So in this section, let's start talking about what we're going to term relations. Relations. Now that builds on something that we've seen before, and that was the product set. And a relation is just a subset of the product set of a set unto itself. So I'm going to have the set A and its product set, just A with itself. And I'm going to call my relation, I'm going to use this uppercase R. That's just going to be my relation. Now let's have a quick example, because that'll explain really well what a relation is. So imagine my set A is just the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And my relation is, my relation could just be divides. Just make divides. So that looks a bit odd, but let's have a look at this. And then we can also see the notation that we are going to use. Does 1 divide itself? Indeed it does. So 1 divides 1. 1R1. Now they are both in the set. It is a product set. And we can use product set notation that we used before. Just in a little bit after, I'll show you this. Does 1 divide 2? It does not divide 3, 4, 5, or 6 without a remainder. Does 2 divide itself? Yes, so 2 divides 2. 2 also divides 4. 2R4. And 2 divides 6. And 3 divides itself. And 3 also divides 6. And 4 does not divide 6. 4 divides itself. 5 divides itself. And 6 divides itself. Lots of squeaking from this almost dry pen today. So this will be the relation of, or the elements of this relation divides. It's a subset of this product set, which means that we can really write this in two ways. Now, if we make this A1 and A2, we can write A sub 1, comma A sub 2, or A sub 2, comma A sub 1. And you'll see many textbooks are going to use the product set notation. So we actually here are going to have that R. Let's get a new pen. That R, my relation, is really just going to equal the following. It's going to be 1, 1, and then 2, 2, and then 4, 2. So 4, 2. And it's going to have 6, 2. And it's going to have 3, 3. 3 and 3, and it's going to have 6 and 3, and it's going to have 4 and 4, and it's going to have 5 and 5, and it's going to have 6 and 6, and that is my set. So I'm using product set notation here, but you see it is just the other way around of this notation. Just check, some do use the notation 2, 4 instead of 4, 2, so just make sure which one you are using. So this is a relation. Let's look at one more relation. Let's have my set A. My set A is the set of all elements X, such that, let's make that 1 is less than or equal to X, which is less than or equal to 20. And I have the fact that X is an element of the set of natural numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 until 20. And my relation is 3 times. R is 3 times. So that might sound a bit odd, again, like that one. So R is just going to be the following. So 3 is 3 times 1. Let's have 6 is 3 times 2. Let's have 6. Let's have is 3 times, so 3 times 3, so 9. It's going to be 3 times 3. 12 is 3 times 4. 15 is 3 times 5. 18 is 3 times 6. So there we have all the relations of this set. It's a subset of the product set of A unto itself, and I can write it just in product set notation. So once again, we're going to have 1 and 3. 1 and 3. We're going to have 2 and 6. We're going to have 3 and 9, and we're going to have 4 and 12, and we're going to have 5 and 15, and we're going to have 6 and 18. So we have those pairs. So that is a binary relation. We are dealing just with 2, just from A unto itself, so the product set A and A, and we have this binary relation. Next up, we're going to just look at some properties of these relations.